Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video today, I am going to show you guys my everyday makeup routine. Now, I say every day because this is something that I would do if I have something to do that day, say like a photo shoot or just something like important, an event, something. I personally don't like to put makeup on my face every single day because I like my face to breathe, and I definitely said this before. I just prefer like the natural look. I get my lashes done and then I just put on some lip gloss and I call it a day because it is a lot of effort. I just like to wear natural looking stuff on my face. So even when I do my makeup, unless I really have to like beat my face, I don't. Like, I don't like wearing foundation, but I'm gonna do it for the sake of this video so you guys can see how I do my full-on makeup routine. I really want to turn this into a chit-chat get ready with me because, so I'm just gonna start. But there has been so many things going on in this world today, and I'm just trying to grasp everything that I've been learning these past couple of days with the coronavirus going on and people being quarantined and just how fast it's spreading. I feel like everybody's been going in a panic mode, and I don't blame them because we really don't know where this can turn to, and that's the scary part. So I'm using this Ines Free what is it again? toner. I always do this before I do my makeup first. But yeah, I feel like it's just so many things going on right now. Like, my school got canceled. Like, we weren't supposed to go into spring break until after today, and today's Friday, so it got canceled, I want to say Tuesday, I think, until like April 6th. I kind of like it because online classes, I feel like it's going to be a finesse, but some professors just, I don't think they'll be able to really teach like technologically wise, because some of them can't even teach in person, so I don't know how that's gonna work. And the lighting is very weird right now, I'm so sorry. I'm trying to have like good natural lighting, but the sun is kind of going down, so now that that's done, we're gonna go ahead, well, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Timeless Ferulic. I honestly don't have, it's basically vitamin E oil, and it looks like this. I always use this in the morning. My sister actually gave me this, and it's like $40, but it's honestly worth it because around this time my face gets super duper dry, and this helps it maintain like the texture of my face. And also, it's a good oil base to use for if you're wearing foundation, because the foundation really glides easily. And I'm just gonna let that air dry for a little bit. I'm gonna use my Nourish Oil-Free Antioxidant Facial Moisturizer from Trader Joe's. I've talked about this product several times. I still use it because I honestly live by it, especially if I'm wearing makeup. Everything just glides on so much smoother. That's what I noticed, because I actually switched a moisturizer and it's not the same, so I switched back. Alright, so the next thing that I'm gonna do is my eyebrows. I always do my eyebrows first. I feel like it's just, when you get that out the way, it's like 50% is done. Not really, but in my head, that's what it is. And I use the e.l.f. pomade type gel. This is in the color Espresso. The brush that I use is this brush, and it also has a spoolie. I'm gonna fast forward this part because I might do, if you guys want me to do a separate video on my eyebrows and how I do it, I could definitely do that, because I always get questions on how I get it like so evenly like aligned. I honestly feel like it's from using like a brow gel. It makes all the difference. If you hate me, 'cause I'm only trying to think about you, baby. It's okay if you ain't clear, 'cause we don't deserve all this shit we've been taking around. Okay, so the eyebrows are done. The next thing that I do is define kind of like the outline of my eyebrows by concealing it. It really helps shape your eyebrows better, and it makes it look neater. So I just use the Pro Concealer high definition concealer, and I use a concealer brush like this. And you want to do this very, very lightly and not put too much product on it, because then it's going to look too much and sometimes it can mess up your eyebrows, from my experience. So after I apply it, I kind of just go in with my finger and blend it out so it doesn't look too harsh. That's how it looks like. The next thing that I do is my eyes. I don't normally wear like eyeshadow and stuff like that, but for the sake of this video, I'm just gonna do every part. First thing that I do is I take this eye primer and I just apply it all over my eyelids. And don't put too much of this, because a little goes a long way with any eye primer, honestly, because you don't need that much. You only need a good amount. I'm gonna go in with my Jaclyn Hill palette. I'm gonna just do a neutral type of look, so I'm just gonna go in with this color first, just a warm color, and I'm gonna put this on my lid. I'm gonna go ahead and take this darker color, this color right here, which is called Pukey. That's an ugly name. I'm gonna take this smaller brush, and this is just going to blend and define it. I'm going to put a lighter color on the inner corners just to brighten up the look, because it's looking a little too brown for me. This is called Sissy, so this one right here. And then we're just gonna take the blending brush again and just blend it. Okay, so now I'm just gonna apply the same color on my inner tear duct with a smaller brush. Now that the eyes are done, I'm gonna go ahead and move on with foundation. I haven't done my foundation in a while, so I actually don't know what color I'm gonna do. I'm gonna blend in two different colors, which is the Tarte Shape Tape Matte Foundation in the color Medium Sand. So that's how it looks like. And then I'm gonna blend the Matte Poreless Foundation by Maybelline in the color Warm Honey, and this is how it looks like. So they're both matte foundations. I don't know how this is gonna work because I haven't done this, because I just got this foundation, so I'm just gonna try it together and see how it works. And to blend in everything, I'm gonna be using this brush. I'm gonna mix them on the back of my hand. I'm just gonna do a really, really light layer, because like I said, I don't wear foundation to begin with. So that's how it came out. Make sure you blend it on your neck. Very important. It actually looks really, really good. And I think it's the Tarte foundation that did that. Tarte? I'm gonna give this like a 10. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Pro Concealer again. I'm just gonna apply a little bit of this, and I'm gonna mix it with this e.l.f. Lifting Concealer. And it is a darker color. I'm just gonna do a little triangle with this. I'm also gonna do a triangle. I'm gonna apply some on the bridge of my nose. I'm gonna use the Pro Concealer one because it's lighter. I'm gonna blend it with my ring finger because it's the lightest. And you don't wanna apply too much pressure like under your eyes because it's very sensitive. You even notice me. You gotta feel me. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my bronzer, and I'm gonna be using the Milan Baked Bronzer. So I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my NYX matte bronzer in the color Deep Tan. Take this Joa Selfie Ready Setting Spray, and it's supposed to make your look dewy. I like to put this on when I do wear matte foundation because it balances it out, and you know, my face doesn't look too matte. So, real quickly, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my e.l.f. highlighter, and I'm gonna be using the lighter color, and I'm just gonna apply this up here. And I'm actually gonna take this and apply it to my tear ducts. And while we're at it, I'm gonna go in with my Jaclyn palette again, and I'm gonna take this brush and take the color Pukey again, and I'm just gonna apply a little bit of this at the bottom. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video, share this video, and put your post notification bell on so you can be notified whenever I post. If you guys have any ideas on what you want me to do, any content ideas, please feel free to let me know, because with having online classes now for like a whole month basically, I have a lot more time in my hands, and I honestly, I'm just gonna film and focus on that. Again, I'm not a makeup artist, I'm not an MUA whatsoever. I don't really know much about makeup. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.